Welcome to the SunShot Solar Outreach Partnership's Solar Power in Your Community Workshop Series. My name is Jason Upal from Meister Consultants Group, and this is Lesson 5, Local Solar Policies and Programs. So in this lesson, we're going to be discussing different programs that local governments can use to grow their own solar markets. And in particular, we're going to talk about three programs: Solarize programs, Property Assessed Clean Energy programs, and Feed-in Tariff, or Clean Contract programs. So let's start with Solarize programs. Solarize programs have been successfully implemented by a number of local governments across the country. And in essence, it's a group purchasing program where residents or small businesses will get together and collectively purchase solar equipment from a single installer. This has a significant advantage not only in order to reduce the cost of the equipment itself, but also to reduce the cost of customer acquisition. And as we discussed in previous lessons, customer acquisition is a significant soft cost that can be addressed through Solarize programs. So there are three key advantages that I want to highlight for Solarize programs. The first one is overcoming the high upfront cost, and it does this through this group purchase model. The second one is that installing solar can be very complex, particularly for somebody that's not familiar with the technology or the installation process. And so through a Solarize program, a local government will actually get together and through a community outreach process, educate and inform community members as to how the solar process works. And the third barrier that Solarize can overcome, which isn't talked about that much, is this issue of customer inertia, where a lot of times customers may be initially interested in going solar, but ultimately there are a number of barriers that stand in their way before they actually sign on the dotted line and move forward with the process. And so a Solarize program will overcome this through the implementation of a limited time offer. So by offering a lower price for that installation for a short period of time, you'll encourage more people to actually end up going through the whole process. It's interesting, actually, if you look at charts of signups for Solarize programs over that offer period, you'll see a huge spike in the last couple weeks because people realize that if they don't sign up now, they may be missing out and not have the opportunity to receive the same price later on. So again, customer acquisition costs can be a huge cost to the solar installation. In fact, in the US, it's actually 10 times the cost than it is for our counterparts in Germany. And this is because in Germany, there are much more solar installations around. People are much more familiar with it. A lot of times neighbors can talk up to other neighbors about how their particular installation works and make their other neighbors more comfortable such that they're more willing to move forward with it. In the US, as we have less solar and it's more dispersed, there are less people that are familiar with it, and therefore for many people, this is still new and unfamiliar territory. So not only do Solarize programs benefit customers, but they also can actually provide a number of benefits to local governments, particularly local governments that are interested in driving the growth of their own solar market. They may find that Solarize programs are actually cheaper than other types of policies and incentives. In fact, a number of communities that have implemented successful Solarize programs have seen costs as low as $5,000 to $10,000, plus the amount of time that it takes to administer the program. There's also a quick turnaround time associated with Solarize programs from when they start the process through when installation is actually happening on customer sites, anywhere from between 6 to 12 months for most programs. And finally, Solarize programs can have a long-term impact on a local solar market beyond the life of the Solarize program itself by creating a network of installers and financiers that are familiar with that market. So the first step for a local government is to select an installer. And that installer is going to propose a set of pricing tiers depending upon how many customers ultimately sign up for the Solarize program. So the more customers that sign up, the lower the prices. Once the installer is in place, the local government, in partnership with the installer, can begin to market the Solarize program. Some examples of this may be providing electronic surveys, through email newsletters and direct mailings, floats in local parades, articles and advertisements, Solar 101 workshops, and having an online presence as well too, through Facebook or online discussion boards. So after the marketing period, there's an enrollment phase where customers can actually go and sign up for the Solarize program. Once that enrollment period ends, the installer will assess each site to ensure that solar is viable. And finally, there's the decision period and the installation of those solar systems. Now, if the Solarize program is successful and they are able to get into the lowest pricing tier, Solarize programs have actually seen up to 30% savings off of the baseline price of solar. So you can see here that Solarize programs can have a significant impact on the overall cost of solar installations for customers in their community. So if you're interested in learning more about Solarize campaigns, I would suggest checking out the Solarize guidebook from the National Renewable Energy Laboratory. It provides a roadmap for project planners and solar advocates who want to create their own successful Solarize campaigns. And this resource is available at nrel.gov. So the next program I want to talk about is the Property Assessed Clean Energy, or PACE program. So the Property Assessed Clean Energy program actually allows local governments to finance the upfront cost of energy investments and then have customers repay that upfront investment through a special property tax assessment. So under a Property Assessed Clean Energy program, the city will first create a land-secured financing district where this type of financing will be allowed. Property owners can then sign up for financing and make necessary energy improvements. The city will actually go out and raise revenue through bonds and provide that capital to those that have made those energy improvements. Then the property owners actually repay that investment, that upfront loan, through their property tax assessments over a certain period of time. So there are a number of advantages to customers over conventional loans. First, the repayment period is typically longer, sometimes up to 20 years. The loan actually transfers with the property. So if the property owner were to sell the property at any point, the loan goes with them to the new property owner. There are also lower interest rates typically than traditional loans, and that interest is tax deductible. And finally, because the local government is actually administrating the repayment of these loans, it tends to be cheaper than if a private entity such as a bank is administrating the repayment of these loans. And this can actually address the profit taxes and overhead costs associated with solar development in the US. Now, Property Assessed Clean Energy has a couple of barriers that it's facing. First, it's not available in every state. So there are currently 29 states in which it is available. And if you're interested in learning more, if it is available in your state, you can check out the Database of State Renewable Energy Incentives, or DESIRE, website. The other barrier that PACE programs currently face is that it has limited applicability outside of the commercial lending space. So if you're interested in learning more about PACE financing, I would suggest checking out the How-To Guide for Local Governments, which is a report designed for local government officials in getting a PACE program implemented in their region. You can find this resource through the University of California, Berkeley's website, rael.berkeley.edu. The third program I want to talk about in this lesson is the feed-in tariff. Now, for local governments that may be affiliated with a municipal utility, feed-in tariffs can actually be implemented on a local level. So, to review what we discussed in a previous lesson, under the feed-in tariff program, a customer will purchase, own, and install a solar installation. They'll then enter into a long-term contract with the utility to sell the electricity at a predetermined price. Along with that electricity sale, they'll also sell any renewable energy certificates produced from the system. Now, to review the components of a feed-in tariff program, it includes a fixed price payment over the period of a long-term contract. The utility guarantees to purchase all the generation from that system itself, and the price that it purchases that electricity at is preset to ensure that the customer receives a reasonable return on investment. Now, there are a number of examples where municipal utilities have implemented clean contract or feed-in tariff programs. To find out more, there are a number of case studies available on our website at solaroutreach.org. That concludes Lesson 5, Local Solar Policies and Programs. Next up, Lesson 6, Installing Solar on Municipal Facilities.